lock. You have opened the lock. In the chest, you find gold, a few items, and an old broom. Interesting. So we've got a remove curse, skull, sleep, fear, irritation, blind, and magic arrows. And then we have... this is a smaller healing potion. This is for poison, I believe. This is magic. This is another balsam. Trading your weapons thing. This is the broom. And we got a dagger. And is that the amount of gold we have? Give how much gold? That's the amount of gold in the chest? Sweet. Well, let's just distribute it. This broom. I wonder if I should have Satine try to identify it. I think that's what Mira was looking for. The herb woman. Yay! So I can actually complete that quest. Broom. I can't cast a spell in here. We got... didn't mean to hit that. We got bashed by water while I was coming here. I know, pathetic. So anyway, we've got our points back for that, which is good. Oh, we on him. Why didn't I not notice that? We cast, have her cast a spell. Here. We don't have to be in camp, okay? Identification. Nothing. Alright. How about the dagger? A regular dagger. Alright. Now there's no quick way out of here. We gotta walk all the way back. Alright, so I'll meet you guys back up top. Where'd you go? She went on top of me so I couldn't see her. She's a lot younger than anyone there. Does she have anything new to say? I'm just gonna tell her about the broom. It's the same thing she's always said. Broom! Who told you about that? The story seems to have gotten around. I ought to change you into frogs right now, but I think you might be the right people to help me. I think the cat outside of Shirkar told us. I have a small dispute with the sprites and the goblins of the forest. They stole my broom and have hidden it in their cave. If you return it to me, I will reconsider and perhaps not change you into frogs. I have sealed the entrance to the tunnel they dug to steal my broom, but you can open it if you say my name to the stone head. You don't have to do that. All you ask is who's... the Stonehead asks us who's the guardian of this place or something like that. Which is obvious, it's her. When I look at you, you don't seem very impressive. You can take my cat with you if you have room in your group. I don't. Now get going and bring my broom back or you will find yourself in the pond with the other frogs. Oh, what a sweetie. Alright, let's give her the broom, which Satine has. At last, it is mine again, and I can fly around all day and night. I think I won't change you into frogs, and will let you go. I'll also give you a tip, because I know very well what you are looking for. Go to the frog pond and look under the large rocks on the island. Yes, we already found the piece of the Amberstar. Does she say anything new if we say hello to her? Can't you leave me in peace? Go away and smash a few orcs. Can we ask her about orcs? Alright. Do we get experience for that or something? Oh well. In any case, done. We found a lot of other useful things. Oops. No, I just don't want to get waylaid by these stupid sprites and goblins like she had mentioned. As long as we get away from her house and the frog pond area, we're good. Now, the others, I'm gonna cross this out. We're actually finally now done with the sprite caves. Breath's Wine Cellar, which I'm not sure is in Twin Lake. I think it's in Twin Lake. Since we opened the area, we can just walk through right through the old tunnels. And there's two chests that are unopened. I'm not sure which one. I think one's all the way at the end, which makes sense, and one's somewhere in the middle. Anyway, I'll meet you guys there. Okay. We're in Breath's Wine Cellar. I guess we haven't opened this one yet. This isn't even to the old tunnels area. I'm not sure if I'm remembering it wrong, because I'm pretty sure Orlando's Wine Cellar just goes out to that island. And that this connects up, but I guess we pass through here? It's a fake wall, I'm guessing. It's been a while since I was through that area. Maybe we already got this one, though. That would be funny. I think we did, then. Because it's not doing anything. I did just... Yeah, it doesn't work. Okay, we must have opened this one already. So... I checked these... This is way back in the beginning. I think this was our first dungeon. This was just piles of crap. We found empty flasks, I think, here. Alright, so then that we must have already opened. It should have... You know, it should show an open chest or something. Not just a closed chest that doesn't react. So I have to go all the way back. There's no way through. This is blocked here. So I go all the way back. Back through here, and then we can't go through here. We have to go all the way up here, and then all the way down, and then hit exit by mistake, and all the way down through here, to here, here, and then all the way up here, 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 and then down, and then down here, and then check this, and then see. I think we can get through a fake wall here, and that'll be in the old tunnels. I think all the chests we want are in the old tunnels, so. They get harder there or something, so I'll see you guys when we find a chest that doesn't appear to have been opened yet. Okay, so I must have searched the skeleton already. Yep, through. Old tunnels. Alright. And then we got this. Obviously this. Oh my. I think this one has yet to be opened. And one of the other ones. Yeah, it looks like a lot of fun, doesn't it? Respond to my clicks, damn you. We just passed that key in the wall. Oh, this isn't even anything. I don't know why I'm checking it. You know I've been there. Oh. This is where we open the tunnel to get through. Do we need two keys? I don't remember. Alright, so if we make... Alright, and then come up through here. Have we been to this one? Evidently not. Okay, so this is... Find traps. We're on him, right? You find no traps. Finding no traps. No traps. Pick the lock. You have opened the lock. Several useful things. Yay! Okay, a silver ring. Two torches, a light 2, and weapons power 2 spell, a lower level healing potion, and a higher level healing potion. Sweet. And 158 gold. We'll just split that up, and then... Jobaneer's been holding the torches. I think Amethyst might have some too, but that's fine. Light 2... Weapons power 2, that's for her. And a silver ring. Ta-da! So can we analyze the silver ring? Or identify, rather. Well, do we already know its properties? Because we have a silver ring already. Well, someone does. Iron ring. Gold ring, iron ring. The iron rings are given extra 1 AC, I believe. Shield 1, oh, not 1 AC, but 1 defense. 1 finger, yeah, shield 1. And I think the gold has 2? Oh, 3. Shield 3. Not sure why, because gold is softer metal than iron. And I have a iron. He has iron. So no one has a silver ring. Well, that's exciting then. I did not realize this. Identify. Silver ring. Okay. There is no AC from it. Pick locks 15. Okay. So he is better at picking locks by 15. Sweet. So he picked a lock to help him better pick locks. And the signet ring is nothing. We might just throw that out. I don't think we can even sell it. So his pick locks is 15. I wonder if it even shows here. Pick locks. Star, star. Meaning over 95%. Okay. I guess we don't need to be putting any more skill points into that. His attack is almost maxed out. Parry could be better, but he's much better, actually. But he stands in the back. So only ranged weapons are going to be hitting him, and spells, which I don't think are affected by parry. So when he levels up, we're going to be leveling up his find traps and detect traps. Exclusively those two for quite a while. Sounds good to me, because those need to be increased. Luckily, he gets a lot of skill points per level. So, a lot more than anyone else, because he has more skills available. So that's one of the chests. And the other one, like I said, is probably one at the very end. But I think there's one more besides that one. I checked these two. This was just... yeah, nothing. I think, yeah, I showed you guys that. Ah, yeah. This has got to be the other one. Now, unfortunately, we can't take this express all the way down. But it's locked off. Yeah, we can't take it at all. We have to stay in this left confusing area. Fun. So, I'm going to cut it off to where we get to the chest. Okay. So now that we have these lockpicks, we don't even need them. I think there's a few things that might only be able to be opened with lockpicks. I have opened the lock. Got to search for traps, but we're okay. Okay, we found an ivory necklace, some scrolls, beam of fire, water hole, mud catapult, a couple more torches, studded leather, a hat, and a knife. And 89 gold. Woohoo. Split the gold up. Jobin here can get the torches. We've been using them, walking through here. Definitely want to identify that one spell. Not spell. Necklace. Ivory necklace. Was there someone looking for an ivory necklace? Last identification spell. Charisma should be plus 20. Plus 20 charisma. Who can use that? Now, Silk already has very good charisma. I'm not sure what we need charisma for besides... I don't know if it has an effect in speaking with people. But other than that, just selling, buying and selling stuff. I'm gonna think about that a little bit. Well, it's not like whoever's wearing it is stuck with it or something, right? If it was cursed, we'd find out. I don't think it has a use in casting spells. I mean, I guess I'll just put it on. Doesn't give us any AC or anything, does it? No. She can't take it yet. I have to figure out what to do with these scrolls, too. Oh, I don't know. Where does it go? Oh, I guess here. For some reason, I thought it would take the hat slot. There was some RPG I played recently where... Was it Pillars of Eternity? You couldn't use the neck and the hat slot were the same thing, so you could only wear either something around your neck, like, of course, a necklace, or a hat or a helm or something like that. It might not have been Pillars of Eternity, so if I'm wrong, I mean another game. Can't quite remember for sure. So. Boop. So now I'm even more beautiful. So, limit for a human being is 60. It's racist. I guess elves have, like, normally a high charisma. Typically, they would. Only 30. I don't know. I don't feel like just... Identifying those other items. So we can get the hell out of here. This, I think, goes back to the inn. See, I tell you, we've been going through these torches. All it's basically done, all the torches we found so far, is making us have the same amount of torches as when we came into the place. Going the right way here. Oh no, I'm just keeping it rolling. The sun's up out there. This way. Yeah, now we just go all the way down. And our torch goes out again. Yep, I just keep going till we get ouch. Ouchness. Ouchness, then turn. You can still see where we are on the map. Cheating, right? Oh, the old villa! We can't... Can we even get out that way? Yeah, I'd rather go back the other way. Well, that goes up to another level, I think. But where does this go? Two level. Oh hell no. This is where Jonathan Bergend, his lab is. I'm going to meet you guys back outside. I'm going to stay at the inn. I'm going to identify a few of those other things. They're probably nothing, but might as well just identify them all before selling them off. And then off screen, I got to figure out what I'm doing with all these scrolls, which ones I'm going to try to learn, which ones I should sell, and maybe a few we should just keep around for the future. Probably more than a few. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay. Ooh, now she can have identification 4 times, okay. Well, it's been a while since I've had her at full, I guess? Alright, probably nothing but this. That's a knife, right? Not the dagger. Let's check the hat, because I'm not sure about that.